Welcome back to UniEdit. Today, I will show you how to outline your research paper. Remember to click like and subscribe if you enjoy the content, and let's get started. Here are the common research paper sections: abstract, introduction, methods, results, discussion, and conclusion. Nearly all research papers will follow this order. Now, we need to write down the main points, facts, and arguments that need to be stated in each section. So, let's start with the abstract. The five things you should include are the research problems, the research objectives, the methods, the key arguments, and the conclusion. Each journal or style, such as APA, may have specific requirements for this section, so please pay close attention to their guidelines. It might be helpful to write your abstract after you finish the rest of your research paper, as the abstract has information from all other sections. The next section is the introduction. A good introduction should state the importance of your research. This is similar to a hook section. State the goals of your research paper. It should have an organizational overview of your paper. And finally, it should have a literature review. This is where you talk about what past research has said about your topic. The next section is your methods. For method sections, you will talk about the study or the experiment that you conducted. This section will be very different for each paper, but generally you should write about the scope of your methods. Based on this information, another researcher should be able to replicate your study. This should include your participants, materials, and procedures. You should describe each major method that you used in your research. Next is the results section. In this section, you must report the results of each major method that you used, and mention if you were able to achieve the goals of your research. The next section is your discussion section. Talk about how the results contribute to existing research, and talk about how the results of each method are significant. Finally, your conclusion section. This section combines all of the other sections together. First, write a summary of your objectives. Then, report your major findings and highlight the implications of these findings. Lastly, discuss the need or opportunity for future research in the field. And this is the basic structure of a research paper. Remember that your professor or journal may have specific requirements, so be sure to follow those instructions carefully. If you enjoyed the content, please hit like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Bye!